And there they are, and all their gleaming beauty fans, 2,000 big ones, silver dollars. They belong to Greg Valentine right now. And Wahoo McDaniel hopes to carry him out of the studio in a few minutes.
That's right, and you must remember that the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship belt is also at stake, plus a man's reputation. Both
That's right.
These men, because
something is going to change hands, David, either those 2,000 silver dollars or that belt of Wahoo McDaniels.
Because millions of people are watching over the Mid-Atlantic Television Network. Who is going to win this match? This is a main event match anywhere in the world. These two men are giants among the wrestling world.
Greg Valentine, and here comes Ric Flair over to our desk.
Tells me what to do, and I'm going to leave just because I know in my mind that Valentine will have no trouble at all pounding that Indian into a hamburger, baby. Woo!
All right, Ric Flair is saying the only reason he's leaving is because he wants to and not because the referee told him. Well, Valentine learns right away that Wahoo is ready. He came with a right hand, and Wahoo hit him right back with a quick chop.
Right. Wahoo now has the upper hand. Wahoo lately has been working more on the legs.
It was a good leg takedown that time by Wahoo as he got right behind Valentine, and Valentine now is going to make the ropes. What an important match, fans, to each one of these men. It's one of the biggest matches they've ever had. It's one of the biggest matches in their careers, David.
Oh, yes, because these two men have been after each other time after time after time. They haven't let each other, they haven't given an inch. Both men just been battling each other. Both of them are bruised from it, scarred. This is the end, you might say, to a long feud. These two men have wanted to embarrass each other, and this is the point, right here on television. It's more embarrassment than it is the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship belt,
right.
Or the $2,000.
Or the 2,000 silver dollars.
It's the embarrassment of losing right here in front of millions of people right here on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling.
I tell you, fans, we were really fortunate to get this match on television, and I think all of our wrestling fans everywhere, David, are just really fortunate to be able to see a match
of this caliber
on television.
I mean, these two men really are giants in the wrestling world. Right now, Wahoo McDaniels has the upper hand.
Well, if he were standing up, he would have a surfboard right there on
That's
Valentine
correct.
As he's got both arms. And he has really got him stretched back.
You notice he's working on the arms right now. He's trying to prevent Valentine from using the bionic elbow to wear the arm down.
He's going to try to get behind Valentine. He was going to try to keep him broken down, wear him down, keep him off balance. There's the knee. One of the favorite maneuvers of Valentine. If he gets that knee up into that midsection, you're in bad trouble. And he just got it into Wahoo again across the midsection with that knee. Hard down across the stomach. All of his weight was on that one, David.
That's right. And Valentine weighs 250 pounds right across the stomach.
Here he goes for a pin with a foot now on the rope.
Now look at that pressure. Look at the pressure he's applying there. Just squeezing with all his might.
He has got Wahoo McDaniel in trouble. That knee, both of them to the stomach, and then that leg across the throat. And now with a headlock. But he holds right on to that headlock. Again, rolling right on through. Valentine refusing to turn it loose.
The vice grip of Greg Valentine.
Not only is so much at stake when you talk about pride and the money in the belt, you got to include the hatred that these two men hold for each other. You can't overlook that factor.
There's absolutely no love between these two.
Valentine with a stomp to the head. And another stomp.
One.
He is punishing Wahoo right now.
Another elbow.
That's that bionic elbow to the top of the
chop.
Head.
What a chop. Another
Valentine
chop.
Valentine now with a right. Wahoo really slinging some chops in there.
That caved it in. Twisting over.
Valentine quickly up on his feet and walks into another chop. The crowd's going to go wild. Over the ropes.
Valentine,
that one sends him flying.
Valentine now very slow in getting up.
Wahoo has got a cut on his forehead. There goes Valentine through the ropes. From that chop, he went staggering back into the ropes, right through the ropes and down off of the apron onto the concrete floor. They are really out to win. They're out to beat each other. They're any way they can. They want to win.
They definitely do. You have to win, especially on television.
It's do or die for Wahoo and Greg Valentine in this match and at this stage.
The hatred between these men is just unbelievable. They have no mercy whatsoever on each other.
Now Wahoo going to be back to the corner by Valentine. Watch out. He could be in trouble right there. This guy, when he throws that right hand, it's like a bomb coming in there when it explodes up against
him. They call him the hammer, Greg Valentine.
What tremendous force he has in that right.
Elbow.
The bionic elbow, and Wahoo looks like he may be out.
How he moved. Oh.
If Valentine had hit him with that one, it probably would have all been over.
Wahoo with a chop at the back of the neck.
He's got him in a stretch, and he's got him pinned.
Oh, count of one.
And Valentine using every bit of muscle and strength he had there to roll out of that one. It looked like Wahoo was going to get him in the stretch, and then he rolled him over for the pin. Just could not quite hold him.
Can you imagine what's going through their minds right now, the move, the counter move, trying to figure out what the other opponent's going to use?
He has hurt Wahoo by going to the stomach, and Valentine has done this repeatedly during the match. He has worked on the midsection.
The hammer in the back of the neck. Another one.
That one almost drove him right through the mat. Wahoo is hanging on. He's not going to give up. Neither one of them is going to give up. They're going to fight to the bitter end. There's the elbow again. To the top of the head. Wahoo on the mat. He's not going to give that belt up if there's life left in him, I'm certain. And Valentine is about the same way with those 2,000 silver dollars.
That's right.
But above all, it's the pride in this match, I think. It's carrying them on. As they slug it out.
Oh,
have you ever seen two men stand toe-to-toe and throw such heavy punches? Wahoo now with the pressure as Valentine is trying to twist and turn and get out of this one.
You know, Greg Valentine reminds me of his father, John Valentine. And okay, he'll take 10 blows just to put one good one.
To get one good one in at you.
It was knee. Wahoo. How about the knee?
He really turned the table on Valentine there. It was Wahoo who went up with a knee. And he goes right back to that chin lock. Valentine now trying to turn into Wahoo, get to his feet again. And that time it was Wahoo who missed the elbow. Valentine rolled right out from under it.
The elbow again in the back of the neck. This has been a hard-fought match.
They have gone at each other tooth and nail. He's got him up. Is it going to be the suplex?
Suplex.
Valentine with Wahoo high into the air. Comes with a suplex. Can he roll over and pin him? He's going to come down again with the elbow. And again, Wahoo rolls out from under. Wahoo McDaniel rolled over, got out of the way of the elbow, and off of the ropes. When they come together, they both go down.
This match is unbelievable.
You just can't believe that either one of them can take much more. The punishment that they have given out, the punishment that they have taken, just how much longer can they continue to go? Another elbow to the head. Wahoo now reeling into the ropes. And Valentine again right on the attack.
Another hard right from Valentine. And another one right across. A chop!
Valentine again with a right and another chop. He backs up a step or two and comes right back in.
Backdrop.
Josh Valentine on the mat, who gets the elbow drop.
Wahoo goes for the pin.
Count of two, and he almost had him down for three. I don't know how he had the strength to get up, but he did, and again, he gets a shoulder up at the count of one.
Oh!
Point blank, right hand, right on the jaw.
Remember, 2,000 silver dollars in the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship belt at stake in this match.
He fell right flat on his face that time, literally, as his nose plowed into the mat.
Suplex! Suplex!
Oh, now he's got him up.
He's got him! Going for the pin. He's it.
Again, a count of two, and I thought that time he would have him. Wahoo with a count of two. Valentine again kicking out.
Valentine still slower and slower. Hanging on the ropes for dear life.
That tomahawk chop sends him reeling again to the ropes. And he comes right back again. It
looks like close. Oh, right across the nose.
Bit of strength. That one right across the nose. Right across the bridge of the nose. And Valentine now covering his face with his hand is whipped into the corner, into the turnbuckles. He said, ring the bell. Valentine now.
He's screaming. Wahoo's screaming.
He's got that leg. And got that leg muscle.
He said he broke it. The referee's saying he broke it.
Saying that he broke Wahoo's leg. And he can't get him to turn it loose at this stage. Valentine still with a leg. Has still got it locked in. And Wahoo still flailing around there in the ring. Trying to get Valentine now to turn it loose.
Valentine won't turn it loose.
And finally rolling away, and Valentine is going to be declared the winner. Greg Valentine is going to be declared the winner, David. He's going to take that Mid-Atlantic heavyweight belt from Wahoo McDaniel. There's his friend and partner, Ric Flair, jumping up into the ring with that belt, giving it back to Valentine. As Greg Valentine holds up the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship belt. He just took it from Wahoo McDaniel.
Referee.
And what has to go down is a fantastic match.
Referee Stu Schwartz saying that Wahoo's
leg
is broken.
Here is Paul Jones and Ricky Steamboat into the ring now. They're going to help Wahoo McDaniel. They're trying to help get him out of the ring. And Jones is going to get Valentine from behind.
Wait a minute. Jones is hot.
He's going after Valentine's leg. And Flair gets him from behind. And here is Steamboat.
Steamboat, look at it.
We got a free-for-all in the ring. Paul Jones, Ricky Steamboat, Ric Flair, Greg Valentine. All going at it. And here it is, as you get a look at how Valentine got that leg in slow motion when he sent Wahoo to the mat.
All right, now watch this. This is a...
Came up with a leg.
This is a leg ankle suplex.
And he had all of his weight on it, David. And that's what did it right there with the winner, Greg Valentine. We'll be back right after this message.